HUD activated. Commence briefing.
Approaching Harad.
Data on the subject. Kadir Suleiman, a local political figure hired to maintain order after the outbreak. His brother Hassan died in a disease-related incident before we were able to evacuate him. Suleiman blamed the GRE for Hassan's death. He stole a highly sensitive file which became his bargaining chip against the GRE, with instructions to publicize it if anything happened to him. Data on the subject. The stolen file.
Jump in 10 seconds.
It details the incomplete process of synthesizing a cure for the virus. If implemented in its current state, the produced substance may be extremely toxic.
Now.
Also, the file contains full description of the virion's structure. Any attempt to use it would result in countless lives lost. It must be recovered. Further information, current status. Suleiman sent the file to an associate unknown to us, with instructions to publicize it at his command at any time. To counter that, we instituted a citywide communication jam, preventing him from publicizing the file. Your GRE-issued radio can overcome that jamming. It is your lifeline. Do not lose it. Suleiman has since gone underground and begun using a different name. We have reason to believe he now leads one of the two main factions operating within the city. You are to find Suleiman and locate the stolen file in order to save mankind from a disaster of unprecedented proportions.
I told you that wasn't a normal drop shoot.
Break his legs, then take him to rides.
Back up! All of you!
Stop! Loud noises draw them. Fall back! Fall back!
On one arm.
Oh shit, Amir's hurt?
No. Amir is gone. But I'm bringing in someone who might still survive.
One of us?
We'll see.
You pinch him.
You're scared.
I'm not scared.
Then pinch him.
He blinked.
What?
He blinked again.
What if he's a zombie?
Ah!
Zombie! Run!
You sleep for 3 days like a dead man, then scare children? Off to a great start, 31.
Where am I?
In paradise, can't you see? Okay, enough joking around. Head to room 190. The boss will...
What do you mean, 31?
Ask the boss!
That's your number.
Excuse me?
Your number. You're the 31st infected. I'm the 18th. Everything is counted here. One fewer doses of antizin. One more new infected. One more runner gone.
Hey, where's room 190?
Upstairs. And you are?
Crane, 31.
Oh, right. How's your head?
My head?
Got it. Listen up. Until the boss says so, you are not on the list. So go talk to him ASAP and let's get things moving. Now, if you'll excuse me.
How do you feel?
I'm looking for the boss. Is he in there?
Oh, you're 31. Go on in.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm looking for the... Are you the boss?
What, am I too young? You got the problem with my age?
No, I... You wanted to talk to me?
That's better. Do you remember anything? Know what you are?
Yeah, I can see this is some kind of shelter.
We call it the Tower. Brecken and his runners put it all together a couple of months ago, and we've been here ever since. Hunting airdrops, scavenging, and rescuing people.
Yeah, I wanted to thank that girl.
Good, because if not for her, you'd already be chewing somebody's knee bone. Your Anderson was totally crushed, by the way. Only thing Jade could salvage was your radio.
Oh, great. So can I get that back, please?
Actually, I think I need it more than you do.
Believe me, pal, that's not the case.
Fine. Take it. You know my runners put their lives in danger? For guys like you. So now you take the antizin meant for someone else, and you won't even share your gear with us? I don't have time to deal with your bullshit. I've lost contact with one of our guys thanks to the fucked up radios we're stuck with. Do something for me, would you? I don't want to see you or your precious radio anymore, so go be useful somewhere else. We don't tolerate lazy assholes here in the Tower.
Hey, be fair. I'm not lazy. I'm just... Hey, boss.
Save it. That last guy I mentioned, he's only on the 13th floor, but he might as well be trapped in a mine cave-in. Come back later. And I'm not the boss. Too young, remember? I'm Rahim. Brecken's in charge here.
Not lazy, you little shit.
Where do you think you're going?
The 13th floor. I'm getting some stuff for Rahim.
13? Shit. There's gonna be some dirty work. But we all got to pull our weight around here, huh?
Jesus. How many people died here? Crane here.
Where were you? We've been waiting for your report. It's been over 70 hours.
I lost my radio for a while. Don't worry, my cover's intact. No contact with the Tower's leader yet. Unable to confirm identity. I'm taking steps to blend in.
Acknowledged. Time is of the essence, Crane. Remember that.
There's one more thing. I got bitten. I've shown no symptoms, but the people here say I'm infected.
Then you'd better get your hands on some antizin ASAP.
Help! Help! Somebody!
What the hell?
I cut my arm, getting away from him. Oh, God. You had to kill him, didn't you? God damn it! That was my brother. I came down to see him and...
Easy, easy. It's all right now. I'll get help. Hey, Raheem, this is Crane. I'm down here on 13. Listen, this guy of yours got fucked up pretty bad getting away from a zombie.
Oh, shit. 31? You went after Mark? Is it safe down there?
Yeah, well, it's safe enough now.
Okay, don't move. I'm sending Lena downstairs.
Hey, hold still. Lena will be here any minute.
Gauze. You've got to find some gauze. Oh, and alcohol. Combine them. That will stop the bleeding. Please hurry.
I try to stay calm, okay? I'll be right back. Okay, I think that's everything I'm gonna find. Let's give this a shot.
Okay, who's hurt?
He's bleeding pretty bad.
Let me see him. Gauze and alcohol, huh? Pretty primitive, but it'll work. Thanks for the help. I'll take care of him from here.
Well done, 31.
I just want to help out and repay you guys for what you did for me.
Well, good. Come find me, and we'll talk about how you can do that.
taken care of. Piece of cake. What else you got for me?
Well, let me think.
Rahim, you are just smart enough to be dangerous, you know that? Omar told me about your plans for the nest. Explosive charges? Really?
What? Explosives?
Oh,
I never
please.
Said that.
You can't tell a convincing lie to save your life.
I know what I'm doing.
Yeah? You think you can't die?
You're not my mom.
No, I'm not. Our mom's dead. So you might want to be a little nicer to me since I'm the only family you have left. Especially now that Amir is gone.
You're Jade, right?
Right.
I just wanted to thank you for what you did for me and tell you how sorry I am for your loss. I owe you and Amir my life.
Yeah, you do. You want to return the favor? Keep my dipshit brother from killing himself. No explosives, Rahim.
So, is that enough? Do I get to talk to Brecken now?
First, go change your clothes. I left some new ones for you in your room. You're in 194.
Something wrong with what I'm wearing?
You need something that fits the job Brecken wants you to do. Call me when you've changed.
Okay, Rahim, I'm ready. Where do I find Brecken?
Not so fast, 31. If you're going to earn your keep, we have to find out if you've got the skills. So get your ass up to the gym. It's on the top floor. Just a couple flights up.
Beware of the night.
Computers.
What kind of stupid question is this?
It's a joke, obviously.
Rahim, I don't see you. Where are you?
Close.
Oh.
at home. A crane on a crane.
Welcome to our gym. First things first, you've got to learn how to run.
What do you mean, learn how to run?
Just do what I say, all right? Now, jump down to the very bottom.
Are you nuts? I'd kill myself.
Don't be a wimp.
Come on, you can't be serious.
Watch this.
Rahim!
My leg!
Jesus, don't move! I'll get help!
Ha! I was just fucking with you!
Son of a bitch!
What? You can't take a joke? Come on! Get your ass down here!
Christ on a crutch. Holy shit!
It's a rush, isn't it? But don't blow your load just yet. There's more. To survive outside, you got to take advantage of the terrain. Most eaters suck at climbing, so the harder the terrain is, the better for you. I've got some typical situations set up for you. Let's see how you handle them.
Good job. Okay, time for the real test. Get back to the crane. Make use of anything and everything while you run. Okay, that's enough. You've got some serious natural talent, man. Either that, or you've done this before. You've done this before?
Hardly. The closest I ever came to this was running track in high school.
Well, then you're a fucking prodigy. Never seen anything like it.
What's happening to me?
Crane?
Shit. Shit.
Crane, talk to me. What's going on?
Something went wrong. Raheem, what just happened to me?
Oh, shit. I bet you're having your first seizure. Just get back over here.
Raheem, what the fuck was that? Does this mean I'm turning?
Most likely no. At least not yet. Caesars remind you that you're infected. You better go see Dr. Zera, though. He'll check you out, probably give you a shot of antizin. Before you head out to see Zera, talk to the quartermaster. He'll gear you up so you can go outside without getting your head bitten off. Well, what are you waiting for?
Alright, they've given me an actual job, and nobody suspects I'm not who I say I am. So far, so good. And once Dr. Zera helps me manage these symptoms I'm dealing with, I'll be even better.
Oh, you're the new scout. Raheem radioed me about you.
Yeah, that's me. Name's Crane.
I'm not gonna bother learning your name till you survive a few days, but here, this is for you. By the way, word around the tower is you're just another deadbeat in line for food or antizin. By which I mean, the people here don't much like you. But don't blame them. It's easy to get paranoid when you're isolated. And since somebody's jamming communications to the outside, there's plenty of paranoia to go around. Whole damn city with nobody to call for help but ourselves. You bring me some supplies from the airdrops, though, and you'll see people change their tunes in a hurry. That shit's a game changer.
Thanks. I'll bear that in mind. Listen, is there anything else? I'm in a bit of a rush.
Also, if you're looking to get more popular, you can try helping folks. Do a few favors, they might like you more. Might even find a woman. Keep you warm at night.
trapped here like rats in a cage. Town, you know?
Who sends the... the government?
Going outside, yeah?
Okay, new guy. Be careful out there. We've lost too many already.
Okay, noob. You've got Dr. Zera set up in a semi-trailer on a fenced-in playing court. When you leave the tower, hang a left and head due south. You can't miss it.
It's Crane, kid.
All right, Crane. Just keep moving. There's no time to take in the sights. And try not to make too much noise. Sound attracts those fuckers.
I hope those rotting fuckers never figure out how to climb up to the top.
Doctor? Hello? Anybody there?
Camden, are you there?
Damn it.
So I'm supposed to get a vaccine?
What? No. Suppressant. It's called antizin. Suppresses the symptoms here. Sit. enters and postpones the inevitable. Best the GRE could do.
Inevitable? So, there's no cure?
It's a variation of rabies. There's no cure right now, but you see, I've been running tests on both antigen and infected tissue. A cure is possible, definitely possible.
Oh shit, you really think you can figure it out?
With Dr. Camden's help, yes, I think so. Now, where did I put that injector?
Who's Dr. Camden?
A colleague trapped in Sector Zero, where the outbreak first, well, broke out. We've been collaborating via radio, though we would have made more progress if the connection were better. Also, if my earlier experiments had borne fruit. I tried injecting recombined versions of the virus into chunks of meat and leaving them around the city, hoping some of the infected would eat them so I could observe and document the results.
But they didn't?
It bore no fruit. I'm ashamed that I wasted so much time on it. No reason to hold any antizen in reserve now. In any case, all right, I'm quite busy, so on your way.
Raheem, Zara checked me out and gave me another shot.
Okay, great. That'll to hold you for a while, which is good, because I'm starting to get used to the idea of bossing you around. So, time for a real trial. Go talk to Spike. You'll find him near Zara's truck. He's got the first real job for you.
Hey, Spike. I'm Crane.
Just what I need. More unskilled labor. All right, shut up and pay attention. There are two types of airdrops. One has food, first aid supplies, survival gear and such. The other kind is filled with antizen. The GRE sends in a one-way video feed that lets us know when they're on the way. Look, the trouble is, the airdrops with antizen keep getting raided by Ryze's thugs. And without antizen, we're basically screwed. Ryze and his boys only operate during the day because going out after dark is a dandy way to get killed. But the next two antizen drops are coming down right at sunset tonight, and Brecken means to go after them. This may be our only chance to reach the airdrop.
What's my part here?
Well, as I said, going out at night is basically suicide. Or it would be if I hadn't been setting up safe zones and traps out there for weeks now, which I have. Now, Brecken and his team will be okay tonight so long as you get out there now and arm those traps. That's your part.
All right. What are these traps and how do I arm them?
You'll see. I'll be talking you through it. Just remember, without these traps, Brecken won't survive the night. And if he doesn't come back with antizen, we are lost. Before you head out there, grab some firecrackers. Made them myself. They make a fine distraction if you get in trouble. first, the car. Open the hood, connect the battery, that'll arm the trap.
Jade here. Is anyone outside right now? Urgent help needed.
I'm outside. I'm working for Spike.
You're Crane, right? Listen, our runner's trying to secure one of our safe houses for Brecken's mission. He's in a courtyard by Vefa and Mimar, surrounded by zombies. We gotta help him.
All right, I'm on it. Okay, Jade, I'm here, along with some infected.
Watch yourself, Crane.
I think it's too late for this guy.
All right. Finish it. Just...
Okay, it's done. Fuck.
You had no choice. He wasn't human anymore. Now hurry. You still need to turn on the lights. That's the only way to make this place safe at night.
Shit.
How's it coming? Got the lights on?
Almost. Just give me a second.
Thank you.
Crane here.
Report.
Okay, I met this doctor, scientist type. They've got him set up in a sort of research trailer, and he's working on a cure for the virus. His name is Zera. Hello? Do you copy?
Affirmative. Secondary objective added. Maintain your cover and secure all of his research. Acknowledge.
Your stolen file still takes top priority, though, right?
Affirmative. We find it unlikely that a single researcher working out of a trailer could produce any significant results. But if he does, we want to see it.
Jade, it's done.
Good. We'll need to prepare more places like that one. We've got more spots picked out for future safe zones. Spike will mark them on your map later. And Crane, thank you. Back to you, Spike.
Right now, you need to get back to our main task and arm the next trap. There's another car close by.
Got it. Infected are all over the street.
So what does that tell you? Keep off the street. Try to stay on the rooftops where they can't reach you.
Well, they're all around the car, Spike.
You still have some firecrackers, don't you? Just throw some into the crowd. Those dead bastards are easily distracted.
What? Done with the car, Spike.
Keep on like that, you just might make it. The next trap's close by, and I shouldn't have to tell you, but don't get caught out in the open.
Spike, these freaks are everywhere. If I need to use a trap, how do I activate it?
You can't. I told you, they're only for the night mission.
Shit. Okay. quite a contraption you got here.
Three times brighter than an ordinary street light. Gives the infected quite the
Okay, lights are all set.
You ready for the next one then? Better hurry.
Fuck, Spike, the whole goddamn district went down. What the hell's going on?
Oh, not again. All right, listen. There's a power substation near you. Go check it out. Hey, this blackout has really put us in a tight spot. We're defenseless here. Plus the safe zones and some of my traps are down too. We need to get the power up and running ASAP.
Ah!
I've got the substation reset, but if the grid shorted once, you know it could happen again, right?
You leave the electrical engineering to me, okay? Just get your ass to a safe zone. You're gonna have to spend the night there.
Thank you.
Crane.
Crane! What can I do for you?
I just saw this freaking weird zombie. He's covered in big green blisters. It hauled ass as soon as it spotted me. You know anything about it?
Not enough information, I'm afraid. But if you see another one, do let me know.
Okay, give me a sec.
First of all, you did great out there. From now on, if you need something, come see me. And to start with, use a UV flashlight and a remote control. You run up on a volatile, give him a face full of UV, or lead him into a trap which you can trigger with that remote. You got it?
Got it.
Perfect. Now for the bad news. Despite your efforts, Brecken's mission failed.
Shit, is he okay?
He's alive. But you need to get back to the tower. Jay called all the scouts in, and that means you.
Crane here.
Report.
I'm about to have a meeting with the tower's leader.
Acknowledged. Confirm his identity and contact us immediately.
Brecken's mission failed. Jade called a meeting in the tower. It's my opportunity to finally meet with Brecken and confirm his identity.
Doing? Where's the...
Good job out there, 31. Crane, right?
Listen, Brecken and a team of runners went after an airdrop last night. He lost the rest of his team to biters, and then Ryze's men ambushed him, beat him to a pulp, and stole the drop. Now Brecken wants to go after the next drop himself, but we can't let him, and you've got to back me up, okay?
For God's sake, you can't even walk straight. We need you alive, you idiot.
Okay, we're going in. Act confident. Brecken? Lena?
Maybe you can get through to him.
Jade, who's your friend?
Kyle Crane.
Look, Brecken, the last thing we need is for you to go back out there. We can figure out another way without jeopardizing you. Right, Crane?
I'll go. I'll do it.
Right. Yes. Crane will go. He'll be happy to.
Jesus. No offense, friend, but you're as green as grass. You can't just...
Crane will manage. He'll start in the right spot. And Lena's right. You need to be here taking care of the towers, convincing them the world's not over yet.
Oh, hell. Maybe one more try before we go to Ryze. Yeah. Okay, fine. Good luck, Crane.
Jade, a moment.
Sure. Head for the cauldron, I'll be in touch shortly.
Look, there's something else we need to discuss. Brecken was hurt pretty bad out there, worse than he wants people to know. He took a blow to the head. Now he's starting to have seizures, and I don't have any Loratrax.
Yeah, I doubt anyone does. Anti-seizure drugs were being passed out like candy when the infection first started. And the stores ran out weeks ago.
Yes, that's right. How do you know that?
Look, what do you need me to do, Lena?
There's a man in town named Ghazi. He's not altogether there, if you know what I mean. His mother had epilepsy, so he used to pick up medicine for her each month. She died 2 years ago. But Ghazi kept going to the store to pick up her prescription. He likes his routine, and Ghazi can be very insistent. So, they kept giving it to him.
You think he's been stockpiling it all this time?
If he hasn't, I don't know where else we're going to get it from. Ghazi lives under the overpass. And don't mention his mother's death. He won't understand.
It is again.
Bahir, is that you?
Look, I've got to get out of here. I need to get my wife and kids somewhere safe.
You know, it seems to me this is about the only safe place there is.
Safest place in the slums, maybe, but the slums aren't safe. It's no place for my family. And I found a way out.
You mean out of the slums?
I can't tell you the details, but I need to get across town, and I can't do it without a gun. If you'll get me one, I'll tell you about the place that hasn't been looted yet. I promise you won't regret it.
Well, how do you know this place hasn't been looted?
Because there's only one person that has access to this place, and you're looking at him. Bring me a gun, and the key is yours, as well as everything you find there.
What's going on here?
Bayer's locked himself in the room. We could hear him screaming.
He may have turned.
You hear that?
I can't get this lock. You want to try it?
Bahir, you in here?
Help me!
Tell me what's wrong.
I can't move. My chest feels like it's going to explode.
Are you turning?
No, no. I took antizin and the pain started. The vial is on the floor.
What you took is junk.
What?
It's fake. Where did you get this from, Bahir?
Please, I need a doctor.
First, tell me who sold you that.
I can't, I promised. This guy is very useful. He brings me things from the outside.
Yeah, like phony antizin? People could be giving this to their kids. You want them to go through this?
No! God, no!
Then tell me who sold it to you.
Yusuf. He's one of the scouts. He lives on the roof.
Okay, I'll get Dr. Lena.
Oh, please, hurry!
What? No. Look, he's not turning, but he needs a doctor. You better have a look at this.
The lot number's wrong. Is this a fake?
Someone on 21 took it, and now he can't even get off the floor.
Aman, get down to 21 now. Where did he get it from?
Yusuf. He's one of the scouts.
Well, he can't be producing it here. Someone's supplying him.
I'll have a talk with Yusuf.
The sooner the better. Don't hurt him. Just talk to him.
Yusuf?
Welcome to Yusuf's Emporium. If it's hard to find, you need to find Yusuf. Whatever your needs, Yusuf has it all.
Yeah, I'm looking for antizin.
Well, of course you are. My friend, this is your most lucky day.
No, Yusuf, it's your lucky day. Because I'm gonna give you a chance to come clean and tell me where you got that counterfeit junk you sold to Bahir.
Bahir? Bahir, you say? Do I know this Bahir?
He nearly died from that phony antizin you sold him.
Phony? Are you sure? You're saying it's no good. I just bought 10 vials from those guys. I paid good money.
Which guys?
Well, that's kind of a sensitive issue.
Which guys, Yusuf? I'm running out of patience.
There's a building next to the drugstore. A couple of survivors live there. I don't know how many. I've never been inside. They have medicines. Some of them are real. I guess from the drugstore. They also cook their own stuff. The guy I deal with is named Bento.
All right, now you're going to burn the rest of those vials.
But they cost me a lot of money.
It'll cost you a lot more if I find you peddling that junk anymore.
Go ahead.
We found two more vials of that fake antizine. Brecken is boiling mad.
Yeah, I bet. How's Bahir?
He's stable. But if we'd gotten to him 10 minutes later, he wouldn't be. This stuff is lethal, Crane. Putting them out of business is your number one priority.
Alright, understood.
Get that bastard!
Many of us would give deal collecting empty pill bottles.
You want to ask Bento?
Yeah, I hear you're selling antizin.
Who told you that? A little bird?
Not just the same person who told me you've been cooking up garbage and putting it in fake vials.
Garbage? My formula is 50 times better than that crap they drop in boxes. Not only does it keep you healthy, it gives you super strength, incredible speed, and laser eyes. I could burn you with one look if I wanted to.
I'm shutting you down, Bento.
Yeah. Yusuf said you'd try to make trouble.
Yeah, well, Yusuf was right.
And you're fucking dead!
Be like that! Now! Let's do this!
Lena, it's Crane.
Yes.
You can tell Brecken that counterfeit lab's out of business.
Good work, Crane. That's a big relief. Are you all right?
I'm fine, but Yusuf tipped him off that I was coming.
I was afraid of that. Brecken was going to lock him up, but he'd already slipped out.
Now, if he comes back, I'm gonna have a word with him.
Not if Bahir gets to...
the man talking about you. Don't worry. I'm not going to call you 31. I mean, we're all people here, aren't we? Not just numbers.
Yeah, I'm Crane. Who are you?
My name is Haluk. Hey, so you've met Spike, haven't you? He's sort of our resident mad scientist.
Yeah, I know Spike.
Yes, Spike will tell you a lot of things. Some things he won't tell, like his real name. It's Rudolph. Or that his birthday is coming up soon. He'll be 50. He doesn't look that old, does he?
Are you saying I should get him some sort of birthday gift?
Oh, goodness, no. He hates birthdays. It's just... Spike was renting a room from me when the outbreak happened. So I guess I probably know him better than anyone else in Haran. You know, he used to teach at the University of Southern California. He decided to take a... I suppose you could call it a sabbatical. There was a sort of an incident with a very attractive young co-ed.
Whoa. Spike walked away from his job and came to Ron because he had an affair with one of his students?
Her parents seemed to believe it was the only way for her to pass his class. Not very bright people, if I had to guess. No. There was no affair. Only accusations. I don't even think it was the girl's idea.
So then, what are you asking me to do for Spike?
Well, if you could just... I miss hanging out with him. Tell him I said hi, okay?
Okay, I'll get right on that.
Where is the safest place in your home for us? I don't know.
Look, I don't know.
No place is safe.
Come here. I've got a special deal for you.
With most of the runners out of action, Brecken wants the scouts to take their place. That means me. We're supposed to go for the next airdrop, right before sunset.
Some of them are clean.
With most of the runners out of action, Brecken wants the scouts to take their place. That means me. We're supposed to go for the next airdrop, right before sunset. Crane here.
Report.
Tower boss is named Brecken, and he's definitely not your man. The other likely suspect is this warlord, basically. Local guy. Calls himself Rise. He's hoarding Antizin and then gouging the hell out of anybody who wants to buy some. I'm on a mission to get Antizin from the airdrop. If I don't succeed, they'll have to come up with something else.
Acknowledged. Good job, Crane. You're doing well. Stay on task, and we'll be in touch. Be sure to call us immediately if and when you get that Antizin.
Thank you.
airdrops fall in the cauldron. So if you start from there, you'll have the best chance of getting to that drop before Rice's men do.
Jade, I'm getting close to the drop zone.
Good. Find some shelter and wait. Most of the drops seem to fall exactly in that
area. There's a crate. It looks intact. I'll check out what's inside. Fucking hell. Hope I don't end up like this poor bastard. Nothing here.
Did you see that?
Yeah, two drops.
They landed elsewhere, unfortunately, but you're not that far away. Get to those crates before anyone else does.
Thank you. Jade Rice's men got here first.
Fuck! Okay, don't try to fight them. Just find the second one. Look for the smoke from the flare. The crate should be close by.
Be careful with that. It's anti-zip. It's fragile.
Okay, okay. But...
what? Why?
Look. Broken.
Get the hell out of here.
Jade, I'm almost there. I can do this. Crane here. I'm about to recover an antizin drop.
Good, Crane. This offers us a new strategy. Time to turn your attention to Rise. Listen closely. It's very possible that Rise is our man. So if you find an airdrop containing antizin, destroy it.
What? What? Why?
It will force interaction with Rise. You can go under Brecken's auspices as an ambassador, if you will.
But there are civilians depending on this stuff.
Our plan is focused on the greater good. Remember that.
Jade, I'm at the airdrop. There's no antis in here.
Don? Fuck! Fuck! All right. Get back here and be careful. The nightmares are awake. Don't let them see.
Oh, shit. They must have heard me.
signal.
Never stay outside at night.
I made it in one piece. Now I know how Brecken must have felt running at night. It is no picnic. Gotta report to him and tell him I don't have any antis in. Lying to everyone stinks, but I know the GRE is working for the greater good.
Congrats, you survived the night. Too bad that run didn't work out.
Alfie's looking for you. He's in his workshop downstairs.
Brecken, come on. I mean, we need Antison. I know, but buying from Rise? You can't be serious.
For God's sakes, I'll go. I'm not scared.
Absolutely not. We've discussed that already.
No, we didn't discuss it. You just decided that
I'll go.
Are you serious?
Well, this Rice guy has never seen my face before. Clean slate, right?
Could you guys give Crane and me the room, please? You sure you're up for this?
It has to be done, doesn't it?
Well, I'm not gonna argue. Reyes's place is over here. Just find out what this will cost us and come back in one piece. Forget that.
Good work taking out that antizin lab. You've saved a lot of lives.
Now, it's only a matter of time before someone starts another one.
The danger is all those empty antizin bottles out there. People throw them away, and then anyone can refill them with whatever they like.
You better start destroying them.
We've collected all the bottles in the tower. Plus, Brecken is offering a $10 bounty for every bottle you runners find out there.
Thank you. Brecken is so desperate he's ready to deal with the devil himself, Rise. And since I'm supposed to determine whether or not Rice is the one who stole the GRE's secret document, well, this is the perfect opportunity. You're Alfie?
That's me. Electricity, building maintenance. I keep this place running somehow. Glad you're here. I was just about to call you.
What's the problem?
Well, it's good news, bad news. The good news is that you restore the lights in the Cauldron District. The bad news is that it blew out the grid near the overpass. It's blacker than your pants pocket over there.
So, do you need it switched back on?
There are two substations. Flick, flick, you switch them on. The order doesn't matter. Then you throw the master in the main station, and it'll light up like a Christmas tree.
I think I can do it.
Of course you can do it. Any runner could do it. But there's a catch. Shutting off the lights has created a little black patch for the volatiles. Bunches of them are gathering there after sundown. So I've rigged a trap. It's already in place, all set to go. Now, if you can get in there and restore the power after it's dark, we can fry a whole lot of freaks in one shot.
After dark? That's gonna be a lot dicier.
Sure. That's why no one's volunteered for this job. But I'm thinking maybe you're a bit tougher than the rest of these guys. Just an impression.
Let's just say I'm here to help.
Really? Good intentions, huh? Hope you've got some guts, or you won't last long.
Can you hear me?
Jade? Yeah, I copy. Something wrong?
No, it's Listen, Crane. We all appreciate what you're doing. And I know you're doing it to redeem yourself. Because Amir died saving your life.
Look, I'm doing it because if we don't get antizin from Rice, people will start to die.
You know, I met Amir right after the outbreak. I didn't know him for that long, but He was the best, most decent man I've ever known. But I just want you to know that I don't blame you. Amir knew the risk. And Crane, we know that you too are taking a risk to do this for us.
Look, Jade, we'll talk when I get back with the Antizen, okay?
Okay. Just come back in one piece, all right?
Thank you.
Right, I'm in the substation.
Just find the control panel and turn the switch on. That'll reboot the system.
Done.
Good. Now you've got to do the same thing in the second substation.
Thank you.
All right, Alfie, two down, one to go.
You're doing good, Crane. But the spotters are reporting all kinds of movement. I think the volatiles have caught a whiff of you.
Roger that. I'm at the main station, Alfie.
You're out of time. There are volatiles heading right for you. You've got to abort.
Just tell me what to do.
Don't be stupid. They'll tear you to pieces.
That's my problem. Now tell me what to do.
You've got to find the main panel. It's in one of the buildings.
Get out!
You seem a little bit
under
the weather.
Keep a distance from Rise's men.
Don't worry. They just... Zera will figure something out eventually. Did you hear?
It's done. Fire it up now.
Hang on, hang on. Eat folks, you freaks. That was good stuff, Crane. No bullshit. Look, I got a field job to deal with. But when I get back, I'm gonna take care of you.
Thank you.
back away. This doesn't concern you. All right.
Yeah, good idea. Get out of here before I fuck you up good. Good idea. Get out of here. This is it for you. I'm not done with you. Don't be like that. Calm down. Let's do this. Face me like a man! Where are you going? You stay here. I'm not done with you! Don't be like that! Calm down! Let's do this! What are you afraid of? Face me like a man! What are you afraid of? Face me like a man! I'm right here! Don't be like that! Damn it!
In the most terrible danger. Please, don't ignore me. I have to say.
Just calm down and tell me what's going on.
I'm Babar Kizel, and I am the victim of a most terrible and ancient curse. I am a lycanthrope.
A what?
A lycanthrope. A werewolf. You have seen the undead all around you. Is it so unlikely that other such monsters are here as well? The Nosferatu, the mummy, the lycanthrope. Dahlia the Witch says I can be cured. The potion of garlic, wolf's bane, and a teaspoon of cinnamon. Help me collect these things and get me to another safe zone. I will pay you very, very well.
Thank you.
should be here by now.